Well, Craig, the players have been in for testing today. Just talk us through what they've been doing and why it's so important at this stage.
Yeah, so lads have been back in. Been doing some indoor stuff today, so been doing their screening for body fats, heights and weights. I've been in with the physios as well, doing some strength-based tests on the bed, some movement screens and some strength outputs with our Nord board as well, some jump screens and also a scat. So yeah, it's been a busy day for the lads, really.
Is this the way you sort of see what they've been doing during the summer, make sure they've been tidying over with the work you've given them during the off-season?
Yeah, essentially, yeah. It's always good to get some data on the lads to see exactly where we're at. We're quite fortunate in that we've had quite a set and structured sort of support team with the staffing and with the players for the last couple of seasons. So we've got some good data to compare to now. And to be fair to the lads, we've been keeping on top of them over the summer. I think the last pre-season and the big break we had over lockdown was good in that we sort of upskilled ourselves for the monitoring we were doing when the lads are away. So yeah, on first inspection, everyone seems to be in good nick and yeah, get the first out of the way and back on the grass tomorrow.
So on the grass tomorrow, what's the plan? Is it basically run them until they die, or what's the plan?
Not quite, no. We've got 6 weeks for that, so yeah, we'll give them a couple of days, but they'll be back on the grass tomorrow doing some speed testing and a yo-yo as well. So again, we'll get a good idea on some baseline data for especially some of the newer faces, especially those graduating from the academy and trying to get some data on them and integrate them into the first team group as well. So be a tough couple of days for the lads. Like I said, they've been quite good in terms of keeping on top of their work they've had in the off-season. So, yeah, hopefully we get everyone through the first couple of days and can really start training next week.
Is what you went through last year as a sports science department, because it was unprecedented what everybody went through in football last year in terms of planning and making sure the players take over. Is that a good base going into a new season? Can you reflect back on what worked well last year and sort of implement it this year, or is it a totally different protocol?
Yeah, it was definitely educational in one respect. We've definitely tried to adapt what we've done in terms of tracking the lads while they're away. I think traditionally it's been a case of you've got 7 weeks off, here's a programme to do for the last 5 weeks of that, I'll see you then. But we've been better with the tracking and the lads are a big part of that as well. It takes a bit of commitment and effort from them to be reporting back. And I think after a couple of weeks they get a little bit bored anyway and want to be out doing something, so that's useful. Obviously, we're still a little bit restricted with the protocols in place for what we can and can't do, but it's certainly made us sort of refine our practices. And like I said, in terms of having a set staff here for a couple of seasons now, it's useful that we've been able to sort of refine what we do and align everything together. And the lads are quite familiar with what we do and how we do it, so it's been a smooth process, really. Yeah,
I know you can look back and be proud of achievements, but you always want to look forward because obviously that's the next thing coming back. But when you did have a spare hour to reflect on last season, it's incredible what your department contributed towards the success, really, given, you know, the injuries were very minimal in terms of that. There was no players missing odd games here and there, which suggests that the work was done in advance to make sure that was protected. You must have been a little bit proud of what went on last year.
Yeah, I think often that the sort of from that side of things, the sports science and medical team will get a bit of credit, and probably if it goes the other way, you get a bit of stick as well. But I think really it was a real team effort. I mean, the demand on the lads sort of churning out the same sort of group of players, essentially, that the squad rotation wasn't huge, especially in the league games, and the mentality of the lads to go through playing Saturday, Tuesday for so long and sort of do what needed to be done. Sort of touched on earlier in regards to the protocols that were in place and the restrictions we had and probably what we really couldn't do to help the lads. So they deserve a lot of credit. And like I said, in terms of having a set sort of staffing structure, we're really lucky. Communication with the backroom team, with the gaffer, Robbo, Tiles, Ben, everyone that's involved in that, down to the academy as well with Scarfy and Matty, you know, the communication is great. We talk a lot, we plan a lot. So for us, it's a real team effort, really. I think, like I said, potentially we could get a lot of the credit for that, but definitely a team effort. The gaffer is really receptive to the information and the data we give him, and he's really switched on around sports science and medical stuff. And like I said, it's a real team effort, really.
How do you plan a campaign in a championship? Because you've got different challenges. There's international breaks, for example, that will obviously, you know, break up the season to a certain extent, certainly in the first chunk of the campaign. How do you sort of look at how you can work with the players during that period when you've potentially got players going left, right and centre?
Yeah, I think we're quite fortunate that we've got quite a big returning group, so we know the individuals quite well. I think in terms of a different sort of season, what we're expecting, it's going to be a little bit more demanding in terms of maybe the physicality of the league, which we're aware of. But in terms of planning, we're quite happy with the way the last two pre-seasons have gone. think the lads are asking, we're probably going to work them a little bit harder. So yeah, that'll be nice. I'll enjoy watching them suffer. But yeah, it's like I said, in terms of the staffing and the structure to it, obviously the gaffer's worked at that level before, and the rest of the staff that have played higher and coached higher as well. So yeah, we're fortunate we've got a lot of expertise to call on. Like I said, in terms of our structure and planning, we're quite happy with the general skeleton to our work and having quite a heavy games programme in there as well. And obviously get everything prepped and planned up. And yeah, like I said, we know most of the lads coming back, so we know where they're at, as opposed to having to recruit 10, 11, 12, 13 bodies halfway through pre-season, which would be difficult. But yeah, no, we're looking forward to the challenge, and yeah, I'm sure it'll be an enjoyable season, hopefully with fans back in as well.
Yeah, it's interesting because everyone looks at pre-season friendlies in different ways. Fans will look at opponents and think, well, we're playing that kind of game or this kind of game. When you're living in a COVID world particularly, what you're looking to get out of a pre-season friendly is ultimately fitness minutes and try and condense it into as little time as possible at that particular venue. So, for example, there's a couple of 75-minute games, 90-minute games. In simple terms, I guess I've explained it pretty well there. It's getting the most out of what you've got.
Yeah, definitely. I think probably one of the positives that come out of last pre-season was that because everything was sort of internal or behind closed doors, that we were able to manipulate quite heavily what we wanted to do minutes-wise. I think traditionally in the past, you're sort of aiming to get people maybe 75 minutes in the game, and you're making 11 subs with 15 minutes to go. It's not an ideal situation for the lads coming on, and it's maybe a little bit of a non-event for them towards the end of the game. But again, we've been really fortunate this year with the teams that we're playing as well, that we've been able to dictate to an extent what we want, and be able to come up with a good match minute strategy that I think over the last two pre-seasons has worked well for us. Certainly within the world we live in at the moment, obviously being safe with what we do and the way we're travelling and the way things are at games, but I think after last season everyone's really accustomed to that now anyway. But yeah, we're hopefully quite a logical method to our approach again this season. And yeah, I think definitely for me, trying to keep injuries minimal, get everyone ticking along and get some match minutes into the lads before the season kicks off.
And just finally, you talked about staffing. I know people might just see your name and Matt's name on a who's who, but there's so many people that contribute to your department, did last season and do this season as well. And that's vital for someone overseeing a department to have that trust in those kind of people to do the jobs.
Yeah, absolutely. I think especially for us stepping into the Championship now, obviously some of the teams that are in the division are massive, even budgets and facilities of teams that dropped out of the Premier League in the last couple of years that obviously we're looking to challenge against. So yeah, we've got quite a small full-time staffing structure, and everyone that's been in over the last couple of seasons with us to help out, whether that be student placement, the academy staff as well, all being based on the same site and sort of leaning on those guys as well. It's magnificent, really. We're really fortunate to work at a club where there is that togetherness. We're all based on the same site. We will see each other every day, obviously from about 2 metres away, but it's great that everyone sort of mucks in and helps. There's some great people here that have been here a long time, and yeah, it's definitely a warming environment that helps. And yeah, all that support that we can get is massive, really, and that's across the departments here. It's not just within the sports science and medical students we have in as well, like I said, across the academy and everyone else within the club. It's definitely a huge help to us trying to prepare the players.